Mold is not for the faint of heart, and if you struggle with an autoimmune disorder that your doctor has told you there's no known cause for, I want you to know that there's science that shows that brain toxicity from mycotoxin poisoning is real and is causing traumatic brain injury with cognitive impairment. That's what the authors of this study said, based on mold poisoning, how it impacts the brain, the central nervous system, the peripheral nervous system, and then all your organs within your whole body. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, certified neurofeedback practitioner and brain health coach. In this video, I want to share with you the underlying mechanisms that toxic mold exposure, even though you might not see it, it's sight unseen. You don't see it, but it's in your air quality. I want you to know that your air quality might be a contributing factor to your autoimmune disorder, especially if it has no known cause. So let me tell you how. We know that when you're exposed to mycotoxins, which more and more people are being exposed because it's being called tight building syndrome. So if you're in a building all the time, which most of us are now more than ever, especially going through COVID, where people didn't leave their homes, if your home has mycotoxins in it, again, that you can't see, it's in the air, that could be impacting your autonomic nervous system and your autoimmune responses. So if you're exposed to mycotoxins, which by the way, I have been, I suffered with severe mycotoxin poisoning, honestly, probably for a decade, but for 5 years that I knew and I tried to get over mycotoxin poisoning, that I am, knock on anything, I have experienced this journey. It's excruciating. I didn't know my air quality was at the core of all the issues that I had. And when I found that out, I was blown away. Hence, that's why I'm here talking to you about it today. Air quality is imperative for health. So if you're breathing in mycotoxins and if they are entering your body through your skin, through your eyes, through your nose, what can happen is those mycotoxins cross the blood-brain barrier. Now, when they cross the blood-brain barrier, they are shown to demyelinate. That means take the sheath and the covering off the neurons in your brain. When that happens, it changes the structure and functioning of the brain cells in your brain. Now, your brain cells can die or can decrease in functioning. And at the same time, it changes the way that the electrical energy basically cascades through the circuitry in your brain. There's a known EEG electroencephalogram pattern that is associated with mycotoxin poisoning in the brain that many people don't know is happening to them. I will get to that in a minute or two. But what happens is the demyelinization changes the structure and function and the circuitry in the brain. That leads to autoimmune response in your cells and autonomic nervous system dysfunction in your brain performance pattern. The autoimmune response is called mast cell activation syndrome. Basically, your cells are on red alert because they've been dealing with toxins, albeit unknown to you, for a long time. So all your cells are on red alert and they think everything is an invader. This leads to autoimmune disorders. At the same time, in your brain, what happens is autonomic nervous system dysfunction. That means that your brain gets stuck in what's called sympathetic dominance. It's stuck in fight or flight. Again, from constantly fighting toxins unknown to you. The process can be excruciating for the person that's being exposed to it because you don't know what's happening. And basically, it will ramp up your physical and mental health symptoms. So let me tell you what it feels like. The primary physical symptoms are skin, gastrointestinal, so you'll have a lot of digestive issues, or you may have acid reflux, your stomach hurts a lot. You may have Sjogren's syndrome, that's burning mouth, dry mouth. You may experience muscle tension and increased pain. Now, these are physical symptoms, but they come from the autonomic nervous system dysfunction in your brain. You may also have general malaise. You just don't feel good because the power in your brain has been lowered. You may have respiratory symptoms from dealing with the toxins coming in. So we know these are the primary physical symptoms. The psychological and cognitive mental symptoms are anxiety, stress response, constant fight or flight. You may have mood issues. You may deal with depression. You may have cognitive impairment, like the authors say, that might feel like brain fog. Or the way I would talk about it is that my brain felt like soup, especially in the morning. It might take a long time for your brain to come online. Again, autonomic nervous system dysfunction. So you may feel like you can't focus, you have low motivation, it's difficult to attend. You may have headaches, a physical symptom, but also impacts you mentally. You may have arousal dysfunction, something that blew my mind in my experience, and now I know that many people have this experience, is that there's no stress response. One time I was almost in a very big accident, and I pull over and my daughter bursts into tears and nothing. I'm sitting there like, why am I not having a panic attack? Why am I not feeling stressed out? That's because your system calibrates slowly over time from being constantly exposed to toxins. And especially if you're being exposed at higher and higher levels, which is how the toxins work, then what happens is your brain is slowly becoming more stressed out, slowly getting into more of the fight or flight, and you don't really feel it coming on until, before you know it, you've been dealing with the toxic stressors all the time. You no longer have a stress response. So what I want you to know is this can be identified in your brain pattern on something called QEEG brain mapping. In the brain map, I can see the autonomic nervous system dysfunction pattern, one of sympathetic dominance, one of possibly lowered power if you're feeling general malaise, most likely having too much of the neutral speed in your brain because your brain is exhausted and burnt out from the constant fight or flight. But this can be identified, and there's science that shows that this is a top way of identifying autonomic nervous system dysfunction in the brain. Now, the best part is once it's identified, there's technology that can re-regulate the brain. So what happens from mold toxins or neurotoxicity that creates autoimmune disorders is that your brain becomes highly dysregulated and highly dysfunctional. One of my clients said it the other day, I've gone through all these other therapies and I didn't realize how dysregulated my brain was, and I couldn't think or talk myself back into a regulated brain. Neurofeedback brain training optimizes a dysregulated, dysfunctional pattern. Now, thankfully, I hardly had cognitive symptoms, thank goodness, because I've always done neurofeedback. I do it a little bit each week. I always have since I found it decades ago to just keep my brain in good shape. And so what that did was it made my brain more resistant to the mental and cognitive impairments that come along with mycotoxin poisoning. All of my symptoms were physical. If you look back at my old videos, I won't have to tell you about the chronic inflammatory response syndrome. I won't have to tell you about the skin issues. You'll be able to see them for yourself. But thankfully, my brain was able to hold on to its ability to think and to feel calm and to feel well. If you are struggling with an autoimmune disorder and you don't know what's at the core of it, I encourage you to explore QEEG brain map. I can show you where it's coming from in your brain, and I can pave a way forward for you to feel and perform better. I want you to know you don't have to stay stuck in the loop that you are caught in right now. I was caught in that loop not knowing that I was being retoxified. I went through so many different doctors, and actually one person cavalierly mentioned it to me. Maybe you're being retoxified by your air. And I'm like, record scratch, back up. What do you mean by that? And when I found out, it still took me 5 years to get the toxins out of my home and my body. So now I'm prepared to help you. If you have an autoimmune disorder and toxins are at the core of it, I'll be able to find out and I'll be able to set you on the path to recovery. All right. So if you want more information, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. You don't have to stay stuck in this. So until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.